Welcome to our parents, guardians, family members, esteemed guests, principal, Kate, faculty, and staff who made it here to watch this graduation. This is not the way I wanted to celebrate the class of 2020. I wanted to look at the joy on all of your faces and see the joy side of struggle. I've been in your life for many years now and saw you grow as freshmen to seniors. This class has faced a pandemic, loss of family, and close family members to sickness and violence. You've experienced live footage of brutality of black people in the streets. Many of our people have rose up in protests. Many of you are registering to vote, which I'm very proud of your solutions to the world's problems. Many of you know that I push you on a continual basis to be better people, to speak your voice appropriately, and more importantly, for you all to communicate well to the faculty and staff what you need. I may stalk you about your grades, I may stalk you about your behavior, but more importantly, I am proud of your success. Look how amazing you all have overcome the recent events that we've had and been able to still obtain your diploma. I am proud of you all, your family who is carrying the weight of the world on your shoulders and still being able to persevere. I'm thrilled for your future and we are blessed to be in your presence. I will continue to pray for you all and continue to be here for you if you need. Once again, welcome to the class of 2020.
Light's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Introduce our platform guests, Mayor Bowser, Chancellor Furby of DCPS, Dr. David Hender, Trayon White, Principal William Hake, A.P. McKenzie, A.P. Cush, A.P. Coleman, D.S.L. DeSilva, Dr. Briscoe, who's our speaker, Ms. Carrington, co-sponsor of 2020, Mr. Ronald Emmons, co-sponsor of 2020. Thank you.
Good morning, family, friends, administrators, teachers, school officials, and lastly, the amazing class of 2020. My name is Aaliyah Clark, and I'm your 2020 resident salutatorian of the Anacostia High School. I'm honored to have a moment of your time today doing all the crazy things going on in the world right now. It is only at this very moment that the fact that we completed 4 years of high school is actually sinking in. I remember walking into Anacostia my freshman year and thinking, wow, I'm going to be here forever, and that the year 2020 is so far away. With everyone telling me to think about my future because the next 4 years I'm going to fly, I looked at them like they were blessing because I was only a freshman. Although this has felt like an emotional roller coaster for many of us, we've all overcame every obstacle put before us. Throughout this high school journey, I would like to thank the Anacostia staff. You all are no longer my teachers and administrators, but now my aunties and uncles forever. And so please answer the phone when I call y'all, because I'm going to need y'all.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory.
Good morning, Anacostia High School staff, families, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2020. My name is Jessica Schimmerling, and I've had the pleasure of being a school counselor for this graduating class since they began high school 4 years ago. At this time, I'm so proud and excited to announce the special awards being received by members of this class. Our first award is going to the class valedictorian, Cameron Anthony. She's a student athlete, one of three recipients of the Economic Club Scholarship worth $20,000, a leader amongst her peers, and an excellent student. She's graduating high school today with over a 4.1 cumulative GPA, which is the highest GPA in the graduating class. Cameron is also the recipient of the Principal's Achievement Award, as nominated by Principal Haith, for these very accomplishments. We're also very proud of Cameron, and we're excited to see what she does next at Virginia State University. The next award is going to the class salutatorian, Aaliyah Clark. She too is graduating high school with the $20,000 Economic Club Scholarship, which will assist her greatly in paying for Lincoln University, where she'll matriculate in the fall. Aaliyah is graduating with the second highest GPA in the class, over a 4.0. Congratulations, Aaliyah. The next award, the Community Service Award, goes to the student in this class who completed the most hours of community service. Gregory Wilkins is the recipient of this award for completing over 400 hours of community service at the Benning Road Boys and Girls Club. We're so proud of Greg for all of his hard work and such an accomplishment in helping his community. The next award, the Student Leadership Award, goes to Kamari Milford. Kamari is filled with endless maturity, joy, leadership, advocacy, and responsibility towards herself and her peers. She has shown a lot of leadership skills throughout our school closure by helping her peers attend their own virtual classes and helping them ensure their own success. Kamari's also grown her own leadership skills this year by participating in a paid internship program called Urban Alliance. Urban Alliance helps instill young people with job readiness training and leadership skills through paid employment. Kamari is going to St. Augustine University in the fall, and we can't be more proud of her. Next, I'm so excited to give out the Citizenship Award. This award is going to Jordan Patterson. Jordan enrolled to Anacostia at the beginning of his ninth grade year and has been nothing but an excellent school community member ever since. I read once that a good citizen has the following personal qualities: honesty, integrity, responsibility, and respectfulness. Truly, those four words really help define who Jordan is as a person. Congratulations, Jordan, on this award. The Most Improved Student Award goes to Antion Miles. Antion came to Anacostia at the beginning of her 10th grade year fairly behind, but has continually increased her grades throughout high school in order to be able to graduate today. She participated in both summer school and evening credit recovery in order to be on track to graduate at the beginning of her 12th grade year, and has continually impressed us with her responsibility and motivation to ensure her own success. This school year, she even participated in a college-level advanced placement course and exam in order to challenge herself. I know I don't speak for just myself when I say how proud we all are of Antion. Congratulations. The Career and Technical Education Award is going to Destiny Lawrence. Destiny has been a member of the Public Safety, now Public Leadership Academy, since the beginning of her 10th grade year. The Public Leadership Academy teacher, Mrs. Williams, nominated Destiny for this award and said that Destiny has consistently gone above and beyond the call of duty and has remained strong, determined, focused, and has never given up. Destiny has been a part of this academy for 3 years now and has helped Anacostia win the mock trial championship during her 11th grade year. Congratulations, Destiny, for this award. Last, but definitely not least, is our Student Athlete Award, which is going to Davon Allen. Davon has been an important part of the football team throughout his time at Anacostia. Coach Lane, the football coach, said that Davon is the type of student athlete who will challenge you in every way, but always stays focused on the big picture. Coach Lane is especially proud that Davon is achieving his goal of becoming a college football player by enrolling in Lincoln University with a full football scholarship. Congrats, Davon. We're excited to see what you do next on and off the field.
Hello, graduates and families. On behalf of our entire community, I want to congratulate the class of 2020. I know this is not the graduation or senior year you expected, but do not let that take away from how proud you should feel in this moment. That goes too for parents and grandparents, aunts and uncles, teachers and coaches, and everyone else watching who helped to make today possible. Class of 2020, you are graduating high school at a time when your voices are needed more than ever. Our nation is hungry for change. The pandemic set the stage for creating a new normal, and the recent protests and demands for justice have made clear just how necessary a new normal is. As cities across the country, including our own, begin to reopen, people don't want to go back to how things used to be. People want a world that is better than before, more equal and more just than before. Starting right now, you have a once-in-a-generation opportunity to rebuild and reimagine our societies. You are ready for this moment. Your generation grew up in a world that is constantly changing, so you are undaunted by the unknown. And not just undaunted, but excited. You are ready to root out injustice in all its forms, ready to achieve statehood for Washington, D.C. Class of 2020, you are ready to shake things up and build the more inclusive America we know is possible. So congratulations, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay ready to make a change.
Greetings to the class of 2020 graduates, families, and our entire DC Public Schools community. It has been my pleasure to be a part of our students' journeys as they look to become business leaders, digital designers, medical professionals, and yes, school teachers. And while I only got to know our graduating class most recently as chancellor, I recognize the unique experiences of being a DCPS graduate that it brings into the world. This class of 2020, after all, I urge you to take this time to reflect on what it means to grow up in our nation's capital, to embrace the bonds of our community, and to enter each day being your true self. To the class of 2020, you were born in the early days of a new millennium. Let that sink in for a minute. You are one in a thousand. For each generation of DCPS graduates growing up in Washington, D.C., it gives you a front row seat to the daily headlines and trending topics. You have heard these stories from your grandparents, your teachers, your neighbors, but now it's time to tell your story as the class of 2020. You will be able to say things like, "I recited poetry from the steps of the Lincoln Memorial. I helped make the Anacostia River cleaner for people and animals. I danced the go-go at homecoming all night long. I attended a mock trial at the United States Supreme Court. I started my school's first vegetable garden with First Lady Michelle Obama. I ate a half smoke from the famous Ben's Chili Bowl. I raised awareness of gun violence, climate change, and immigrant rights and social justice. I shook hands with President Barack Obama, and I marched peacefully in my city to protest against police brutality and walk down Black Lives Matter Plaza. Your story is about our hallways and our sidewalks in your school. It's about cheering so loud at the turkey bowl that your voice goes hoarse. It's about the inside jokes between you and your closest friends. It's about balancing school, job, family, all the commitments that you have, but yet and still maintaining good grades and still remembering those that are no longer with us. You did what many cannot do, and while this year did not turn out as we predicted, one thing we know for certain is you work hard and it will not go unnoticed. We're not celebrating you in person today, but we are still celebrating you. DC Public Schools is proud of our graduates, and we know you will go on to accomplish things that we cannot even think of in this moment. It is why the class of 2020 will be the very first DCPS Persist class, as a new program is being launched to provide graduates with special resources that will be available to them as they begin the next chapter. We want every DCPS student who goes on to college to have the support and the guidance they need to succeed as they earn their degree and pursue their path of a fulfilling career. You are entering the world as a DCPS alumna, and we hope that your success has become a source of inspiration for future graduates. I cannot wait to hear what you have to say, to see what you are doing, and experience what you are creating. To the class of 2020, I salute you on behalf of the entire DCPS school community. We all say, congratulations, class of 2020.
Greetings, Principal Hayes and administration team, staff, students, family, and friends. Thank you for joining us on this memorable day. Aren't you glad we made it to this point? My name is Cameron Anthony, your 2020 valedictorian. Know that I am so proud of my classmates for being able to say that they are graduates of the Anacostia Senior High School. Even though we are unable to experience a true ending to our senior year, I want to thank administration and our teachers for making the best out of our unfortunate situation. As we embark on this new journey, things are going to change. This new journey is a time for us to stand on our own 2 feet and use the vast resources and life skills that Anacostia has taught us. When I was in middle school, I was first introduced to Anacostia by my training coach, Shaq. And ever since then, I knew I was going to graduate from. I wanted to be an Indian for life. I wanted to take a moment to thank some of the staff members that have truly made an impact in my 4 years at Anacostia. Thank you, Ms. Sowers, the first teacher that truly challenged me. I hated math, but she made it sure I never took the easy way out. I would like to thank Ms. Bird, my mentor and the teacher to my favorite subject. She always made learning fun, and any student that has her is blessed to have her as a teacher. Next, I would like to thank Ms. Sodas and Mr. Shaheen, two of the best English teachers in this building, that constantly challenged me with the vast readings that will definitely prepare me for college. Next, Mr. Edmonds, who always fought with us and for us, no matter what was on the line. He made sure we only got the best. Last, but certainly not least, my two headaches, Ms. Joan and Ms. Addison, the two phenomenal women that held my hand through every college process. They were always there to answer my calls. It didn't matter if it was 12 o'clock at night. I knew they were going to answer. I'm glad I met them and gained lifetime honesty. We have gone through the battlefield trying to reach this point. We have lost classmates due to unfortunate circumstances, and we've been counted out constantly. Back in the day, we stand tall with our hands held high and diplomas in hand. We cannot let a system that was not built for us break us down. We have to remain resilient through the many adversities that we face as being Black youth in America. We are the strongest class. I know we hate to say, but we really do have perfect vision. We have fought to be accepted into schools and career paths. We have fought to make a better name for our school. I want to leave you with this quote from my favorite coach, Don Staley. A lot of people notice when you succeed, but they don't see what it takes to get there. Again, I would like to say congratulations to the class of 2020. We finally made it.
Good morning, family and friends, and class of 2020. My name is Davon Watts, a member of class of 2020. It is an honor to introduce Patricia Briscoe. Dr. Briscoe retired from the DC Public School System in September of 2018. After 43 years of service, she worked as a teacher at Anacostia, Spangon, and Eastern Senior High School. During her 14 years at Anacostia, she taught mathematics and coached basketball, cross country, track and field, softball and cheerleading. After leaving Anacostia in 1989, for 22 years she worked in the Department of Athletics as a coordinator of athletics and the assistant director of athletics. In 2012, she returned to the classroom at Spangon, and in 2014, she accepted the responsibilities of a teacher and an athletic director at Eastern High School. In 2016, she transitioned into a full-time athletic director position until her retirement in 2018. Dr. Briscoe was the first African-American female to serve on the board of directors of the NIAA, and was the first female second vice president of the DC Coach Association. She is married to the coach, Frank Briscoe. They have one son, Jerome. She is a member of Pennsylvania Ave Baptist Church and Delta Sigma Theta Sorority.
Good morning. First, giving honor to God for his grace and mercy, which is allowing us to be in this place at this time. Good morning, Chancellor Furby, Principal Hank, Councilman White, honored guests, the faculty and staff of Anacostia Senior High School, friends and family, alumni, and the class of 2020. As a proud graduate of DC Public School, specifically Anacostia Senior High School's class of 1971, I'm honored to share this moment with you. I am truly blessed and highly favored. I cannot believe it has been almost 50 years since I sat where you sit with excitement, expectation, and anticipation. We are here to congratulate you for completing your senior year in high school. We are also here to celebrate your graduation and what might be considered your rite of passage from childhood into adulthood. We also want to commend you for seeing the task through. It was not easy for most of you to go from in-class instruction to a virtual class, but you did what you needed to do to meet the academic requirements, and I am very proud of you. This is not an ending, but a beginning of a new path toward achieving the goals you set many years ago. For some of you, the goal was to attend an institution of higher learning, which could be a college or a trade school or the fire or police academy. For others, it might be direct employment into the workforce. For those who have not quite made up their mind where they want to go next, take advantage of UDC's Workforce Development Program. You can earn certificates in several fields at almost no cost as a resident of the District of Columbia. Whatever step is next for you, you are prepared. There will be obstacles as life continues to present roadblocks through adulthood. Who was expecting the pandemic? No one. But we adapted and made it through. The pandemic is not over, but we will continue to adapt and face whatever it throws at us head on. Do not be deterred by the naysayers who do not give you credence to your ability. Do not listen to those who will imply that you do not deserve these opportunities because you are male or female, or due to your ethnicity, or where you went to school, or where you live. I fought those battles too. And when I tell anyone that I graduated from Anacostia Senior High School, which I'm very proud to do, I still fight those battles. Do not let anyone derail you from your goal. There will be challenges as you follow this path. We, Anacostia alumni, are made of strong stock. We have no doubt that you are up to the task of representing what we stand for. You have met challenges these past months. You missed your prom, but you have overcome. You missed your class trip, but you have overcome. You missed walking across the stage to receive your diploma, but you have overcome that too. There is no challenge that can't be met and defeated. I leave you with these words from an unknown source. Whenever you find yourself doubting how far you can go, just remember how far you have come. Remember everything you have faced, all the battles you have won, and all the fears you have overcome. You have so much to give. Come back and give to your community. Come back and give to your school. Congratulations again, Thank you.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Samuel Green. I am a graduate, class of 2017. Class of 2020, congrats. You made it. You did it. You did your thing. I just wanted to say congratulations. And I know it's a lot of people and things out here trying to oppress us and things like that. But I promise you, if you keep God first, change is going to come. Born by the river in a little tent. Oh, and just like the river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Yes, it will. It's been too hard to live in, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the skies. It's been a long time coming, but I know change gon' come. Oh, yes, it will. See, I go to the movies and I go downtown. Somebody keeps telling me, don't hang around. It's been a long time coming. But I know a change gon' come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me please. Oh, knocking me back down on my knees. Lord, there've been times that I thought I wouldn't last for long, but I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change don't come. Oh, yes, it will.
Greetings to you, Principal Hay, Chancellor Furby, Mayor Bowser, Councilmember White, and to you, the Dynamite Class of 2020. I, Ronald Edmonds, bring you greetings and salutations. I first would like to say it has been an honor to serve you as your class sponsor this year. I have been a class sponsor at least 10 years over the past 26 year plus year in my career. This has been one of the most exciting and experiencing years as class sponsors. I know you. Many of you may say, how is that? Well, I'll begin to tell you. I am honored to have served as many of these young scholars, U.S. government, as well as D.C. history teaching. In a time of social unrest, in a time of pandemic, and in an election year, it is you, the graduates of 2020, that will take the mantle and run. I say to you, I believe in you. I know you can do this. I think of you as 2020, I think of perseverance, not giving up. When I think of 2020, I think of you, the smiles that greeted me daily, even when I wasn't doing so well. When I think of 2020, I think of you, the young guys who would come and just let me know how everything was, Mr. E. Know you are special. Know you will persevere. As we move on and you go into the next chapters of your life, know there are going to be challenges such as this one. But guess what? You have gotten through and overcome much. You have overcome 4 years of Anacostia High School. You and I, too, will share that at the end of this ceremony. As a graduate of the class of 1988, I am proud to be an alum along with you. I share with you heartfelt emotions as you move forward. Wherever it is you may be, if you're going to the fire cadet, kudos. If you are a public servant, kudos. If you are going to higher learning into education such as Lincoln, such as South Carolina State, such as VSU, such as wherever it is you may be going, kudos to you. Take the mantle and run with it. I would like to leave you with a special quote from one of our own here in Washington, D.C. Frederick Douglass always reminds me, and I would like to remind you, without struggle, there is no progress. Continue to be the best. Continue to strive for the best. And I know you will persevere. Congratulations to all of you, to the class of 2020.
Class of 2020, welcome. You have made it. This ceremony is one example of you sacrificing and doing the things that you need to do to be here today. I want to take a moment first to thank your parents, thank your 12th grade team led by AP McKenzie, and a special thank you to Mr. Edmonds for the work that they put in to support you throughout this year. In your last 4 years, you have experienced so many traumatic events, childhood adverse effects, and you have been able to overcome those things to be here today. You should be rewarded, and this is your reward. We look forward for you going into the community to be stewards, to support your community, and bring about change that you, and only you, can do. In the next 4 years, I expect for you all to either graduate from college or be working in a career of your choice and being an example of and from Anacostia High School. I'm also asking you and assigning you a task. Stay connected to your classmates. Challenge them as they go through whatever decisions that they're making. Continue to be a positive thought in their mind by reaching out and calling and checking on them. I'm asking you to support your fellow classmates and encourage them to do what is right. Because when you look in today's society, there are so many things that are making us at a disadvantage to do the things that we want to do. My favorite movie is The Great Debaters. And it is a saying in that movie that I live by and that I continue to live by. And I want you to hear the words. We must do what we have to do in order to do what we want to do. Those words have resonated with me for so long, and I challenge you to listen to those words and understand why you have to get this certification. Understand why you have to get that diploma, that college degree, or go into this program, or get that program. Because these are the things that you have to do in order to do what you want to do. So the challenge, think about it. Reflect on what you want to do. And think about the steps you have to take to get there. As AP McKenzie said, I will also pray for you, and I'm so excited about today. Congratulations, class of 2020. class of 2020. And now, by the power vested in me by the mayor, Mary Bowser, of the District of Columbia, and by the Chancellor of the District of Columbia Public Schools, Dr. Lewis Ferrer, I hereby certify that the class of 2020 have completed the requirements for graduation from Anacostia High School. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2020 from Anacostia High School.
Congratulations, class of 2020, Anacostia High School. On behalf of Mayor Mariel Bowser and Dr. Lewis Farabee, the Chancellor of DC Public Schools, I enthusiastically accept the class of 2020. Congratulations and do big things. We look forward to seeing you as alumni when you return to celebrate your accomplishments from DC Public Schools. Congratulations again.
I now hereby certify that the members of the class of 2020 have completed the requirements for graduation from the District of Columbia Public Schools. On behalf of Mayor Bowser, I enthusiastically accept the DCPS class of 2020. Let's give a big round of applause to our graduates.
And now, it is that moment in our ceremony that you, class of 2020, will affirm and take the oath that I and so many others have done before you. At this time, would the members of the graduating class of 2020 from Anacostia Senior High School please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I do solemnly affirm as a graduate of Anacostia Senior High School that I will give mental, moral, and financial support without reservations to my alma mater in order to support and promote the education and social growth of the students at Anacostia Senior High School. Congratulations, the graduates in the class of 2020.
We, the class of 2020, would like to thank all of you who made this virtual graduation possible.
It's that little Chico Pitbull, Mr. 305, but it said Mr. Worldwide, and I'm checking in to speak to the graduating class of 2020.
Felicidades en su graduación, la clase de 2020.
Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Congratulations, Washington, D.C., class of 2020.
I want to, first of all, congratulate each and every one of you for obtaining such a monumental event in your lives.
I want to personally congratulate you on this great milestone you have achieved in your academic career.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Enjoy your day. Dance like you've never danced before. Make the most of this quarantine, because tomorrow the real work starts. Tomorrow the work of being a change agent and changing the world starts.
I just wanted to say how incredibly proud I am of every single one of you. This was not an easy year. And you continued and you pushed through.
You are the first and the freshest of graduates who will face down this pandemic and its aftermath. So pivot. Bring your ideas, energy, and urgency to bear upon this situation. Be leaders in helping us to address it and all the other challenges we face in the world.
We need your energy. We need your creativity. We need your courage and boldness. We need you to be willing to step out and to change the world, because the world is in dire need of change.
Ustedes son parte de una clase muy, muy especial. Esto viene siendo en 2020 la clase más histórico de todo el mundo.
When you get on campus, I want you to be a leader, okay? It's gonna be a lot of people in your way. I want you to keep a tight knit bond with family and friends back home, and I want you to take it every day at a time, all right?
Go into your lives, go into your futures, stay focused, stay humble, stay loving.
I want y'all to continue to strive to be the best that you can be. I know this is some crazy times right now, but you got through it. You got through it.
I want to see you all become the next millionaires, the next billionaires, the next business owners. So hold it down for the District of Columbia. Keep moving forward. Never give up. And always think about what you overcame.
So I can't wait to see what the class of 2020 comes up with. We are watching. We are proud of you. We are so excited for you. And just go out there and kill it.
I know from witnessing the art you've created, the service projects you've already pioneered, and the level of civic engagement you've already demonstrated, that you as a class and as a generation coming to adulthood are going to be able to surmount the challenges that come your way.
The DC public school system is very, very special. You are a very special class, and I just want to wish you the best for your journey into the future.
Keep pursuing everything that you want. Make sure you guys reach for the stars, and make sure you guys understand that you guys are DC public school graduates. Yes, go DC public schools, DC public schools. Let's go.
God bless you. Congratulations. And stun on them. Stun on them. Stun on them. You're out. You made it.
Congratulations, DCPS class of 2020, on your graduation.
Wishing you all the best for the future.
and hope you'll stay safe out there.
Congratulations again to the class of 2020. You've gone through something special, and that makes you guys very special.
So as you go forward from this moment, love more, dream bigger, be stronger, and never, ever, ever give up.
Mama called, seen you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. Was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags.
Stands on noble arms.